And today I'm speaking about the Magi. Last week I spoke about the shepherds who went to visit our Lord Jesus, and they saw the babe in a manger. And today I'm going to speak about the Magi. These were a group of wise men who traveled from the east, and they came to see Jesus, the boy, the very young boy. But I want you to note the fact concerning Joseph and Mary. And we read this in verse 19 of Matthew chapter 1. Then Joseph, her husband, being just man, and not wanting to make her a public example, Mary was with a child. It says she was found with a child of the Holy Spirit. He didn't want to humiliate her. He wanted to find a way by which this could be handled in just the right manner. But when he thought about these things, behold, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream, saying, Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take to you Mary, your wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. You are the father, but you're not responsible for that child. That child has been conceived by the Holy Ghost. And she will bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. And here's the purpose for Jesus coming to this earth. For he will save his people from their sins. So all this was done that it might be fulfilled that which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying, Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and thou shalt call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. Now, Jesus was born in the manger. He has been visited by the shepherds. Now another group is going to visit him. And we find mention of this group in Matthew chapter 2, verse 1. Now after Jesus was born in Bethlehem, his birth is past. Born in Bethlehem in Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. There's a question as to who these wise men were, but it says they came from the east. They could have come as far as, oh, we don't know. But they were wise men. They came from a distance, and they saw a star, and they wanted to follow the star because this star had special meaning to him. This was a miraculous star, not one high in the sky, but one within easy sight by these individuals. And so the wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who has been born King of the Jews? For we have seen him star in, seen a star in the east, and have come to worship him. And they spoke this to Herod the king. He was king of the Romans in Jerusalem. And he's going to be frightened, because they're saying, We have seen the King of the Jews. This is one who is in opposition to Herod, who is king of the Romans, king of Jerusalem. So when Herod the king heard this, he was troubled. And not only was he troubled, all Jerusalem was troubled with him. And when he had gathered all the chief priests and the scribes of the people together, he inquired of them where the Christ was to be born. He wanted to know the birthplace. Now he did not have good intention. He wanted to know for a purpose, because he didn't want to be displaced. He didn't want the Jews to rise up and follow this babe, this young child that's born, who is going to be king of the Jews. He wanted to reign over the Jews. And so he gathered together his individuals. He wanted to find out where the birthplace of this child was. So they said to him, In Bethlehem of Judea, for it is written by the prophet. And so they turned and they made a quote from the Bible. And here is the quote. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are not the least among the leaders of Judah. For out of you shall come a ruler who will be shepherd, who will shepherd my people Israel. Notice, in Bethlehem, the land of Judah, will be born this king of the Jews. Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from whom what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, Go and search carefully for the young child. And when you have found him, bring back word to me, that I may come and worship him also. He didn't mean that. He wanted to find this young child. He wanted to put to death this child. And so he's being very deceptive with the wise men. When the wise men departed, and they had heard the king, they beheld the star. See, the star appeared again. They saw it in the east. They headed toward the Holy Land, and then the star appeared, and they followed the star from Jerusalem to Bethlehem, and then the star appeared over the house in which Jesus was. You see, he's no longer in the manger. He's now in a house. And when they come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and they fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, notice this, the contrast to the poor shepherds, when they came and saw Jesus in the manger, they had no gifts at all. They only came. They had that first sight of God upon this world. They had been given that privilege, but they gave no gifts. They saw the humble place in which Jesus was born, just in a manger in Bethlehem. But in contrast now, the Magi come to a house where Jesus is, perhaps a very humble house, and they bring him gifts. And these are gifts of wealth, which they present to him: gold, frankincense, and myrrh. Then, being divinely warned in a dream that they should not return to Herod, they departed for their own country another way. And so Jesus has been honored by means of the wise men. And these individuals have recognized this child as the Son of God. And so we have two witnesses here in Scripture. First of all, the witness of the shepherd. The message came from the angel. And then the message from the Magi, who followed the star to Bethlehem and saw the Lord Jesus in his house. Jesus was born for a purpose. He was born to provide salvation for all individuals upon earth. He came to this earth as the Son of God. He was God indwelt. He was man indwelt by God. He manifested the power of God. He taught the words which he himself gave expression to as God. That's a wonderful thing, to have confidence in God. There was this little girl who was on a train, and the train was going at a terrific speed. It would go around the curves quite fast, and you would hear the screeching of the brakes, and everybody was quite fearful. But this little girl sat there very relaxed. And so a woman said to the little girl, "Why are you so relaxed under these conditions? It seems that we might be in danger." And the little girl said, "No, I'm not afraid. The engineer is my father." Now that's the great truth of life. There's no reason for us to be afraid, afraid of life, afraid of the end, because we have an engineer, our Lord Jesus, who is our Savior. He cares for us now, and he will look after us unto the end. Have you placed your faith in this Savior, the Lord Jesus? This is Ron Holden speaking today.